Well, good morning, guys. It's nice and early here in Denver, Colorado. So I wanted to bring today, I talked to you on previous videos about doing like a morning routine video because, you know, seeing our training, you know, nutrition, that's just half of it. Like being, if you want to be a successful bodybuilder or, you know, trying to change your physique, you have to put in work just outside that hour and a half of training. So every morning, you know, I have a routine going on now that we're in prep. It involves cardio, usually some posing. Matters on the day, but always like 5 days a week is the cardio, then posing most of the days, then also abs, or if there's something else specific I need to work on, you know, I have a stretching routine that we do as well. So what this looks like though in the morning, first thing I want to show you exactly what my morning looks like. So just woke up, and first thing I do is I do my kind of, I call it my greens drink, when it used to just be greens, but now I have added a lot of other stuff to help with digestion that I have seen works very well. So I wanted to share it with you, and maybe it's something you can try if you're having issues with digestion. So I was having more issues obviously when I was eating a lot more right before prep. Just the process of, you know, continuing to try to push down, you know, push 6,000 calories through you was taking a toll on digestion. Now it's got a lot better, but I've kept this stuff in because I think it really works. So what that involves is first, I scale it here. I do 2 ounces of lemon juice. This is solely going to be for digestive purposes. So glutamine powder, you can get a big one of these. I do 10 grams in the morning, and I do another 15 grams during my workout. So I end up doing about 25 grams of glutamine powder a day, and that's probably one of the main factors I've seen digestion better. So all of my clients do that if they're having issues, and that usually fixes it up. I started doing this aloe vera gel. Probably haven't heard about this, not very common, but this is also one that's very good for digestion. It's kind of a very weird substance. It's really thick and tastes actually all right, but it's kind of interesting. But it really, like I said, once I started implementing that, it seemed to help a lot as well. So 2 ounces, that's why you have to weigh it. Bunch of chunky coming out, but it mixes well. 2 ounces of that. I always do my Revive collagen powder. This is just for bone, joint strength, you know, hair growth, nail growth, just overall really great supplement. I contribute like to not having very bad or having very much injuries involving joints to this. I don't have any knee issues, no elbow issues, so I think collagen powder is very important. And Revive, ever since I started taking that 2 years now, it's been very good. And finally, like I said, like you guys all noticed in my food video back, you know, when I posted that I don't do much greens during the day. That was mainly because, you know, I was eating so much I don't want to waste, you know, I don't want to fill up myself with vegetables when I can just do a greens powder. That's a different way. And I honestly, it's a funny story, I didn't even start eating vegetables until I started bodybuilding. So I was a very, very picky child, even into my early 20s. I did not eat vegetables at all, or fish. So it's crazy to think, you know, what bodybuilding did to me, it forced me because I got hungry. I had to eat fish, I had to eat vegetables to fill me up. So now I do, I'm back on the vegetable grind. I throw it in with a few meals now. But what I also do is I always do this daily greens in the morning. This is just the chocolate flavor from Revive as well. So this gives you all your essential, you know, micro minerals for vegetables and fruits as well. It has a little bit of a digest aid in there too. So really like these. So this is gonna be my setup for my morning drink. So I'll drink this. I drink this with my pills. So come over here real quick. So with my shake, I'll take down my pills. I do this fasted. Like I said, I don't usually eat until about like 9 o'clock, till after cardio, after posing, till like I get close to starting working. And that'll be that. I still am doing that shake. I showed you the egg white shake, it's just a little bit lower. But so what I'll do with this, with the greens drink right now, is I'll do some kidney. I think these are the most essential ones. I do these right in the morning. Kidney, liver, lipid, which is gonna be for your cholesterol. Vitamin C, of course, the importance of that. Omegas. I do a B complex because I found out I was a little deficient in that. So I do that in the morning, these two. COQ10, which everybody I think should be taking. And I'm just starting to do this one. This is Revive's brand new product, Brain Plus. It's like a stimulant-free focus support. So, you know, just being busy in the morning, I just want to try it out because I don't take very much like caffeine. I don't do much coffee or anything. So I'm going to give this a try this week. So that's what my morning looks like. I have one more I need to do, immune multi. I forgot about that one. Oh, which is right here. This is just your multivitamins in the morning. And yeah, so like I said, I'll take the majority of my pills in the morning because then like I'm just busy, so I'll do a few more throughout the day, and then I'll do the ones I need to double up on at night. So this is what a morning looks like. So we're gonna drink the shake, get these pills down, and then we're gonna go to the gym and get started. This is for the guy that I should use protein instead of eggs. I'm getting enough protein. I don't need just the protein powder. There's more to eggs than just the protein. But why don't you use whey protein instead of eggs? Because they're not the same thing at all. Pretty good at guessing this. Oh, what to do? Telling you, watch your butt. Not sticky anymore, is it?
Nope.
It's not that easy. Just got to the gym, so our first thing first is cardio. Right now we're doing 20 minutes of cardio, that's it. But I'm doing 5 or 6 days a week. I alternate between doing a recumbent bike and also Stairmaster. I just started doing the Stairmaster this week, so really starting to crank it up because I want to make sure that we're not, you know, we don't drop too fast with me. So it's kind of just, you know, keeping things under control, being, you know, conscious of weight. And so today I'll do the bike. So that's what's lined up today, as well as you saw the previous video we did the hamstrings yesterday, so pretty smoked today. So I'll do the recumbent bike, still getting a good pace there. You're trying to, you know, break 110 beats per minute on your heart rate, get your sweat going, just a, you know, good 20 minute session, and then I'll lead us in, get us warmed up, to hit a little bit of posing, and if we have time we'll do the little abs as well. So I'm gonna show you that right now and let's get after it. Okay, so going through our posing here, you know, already got a little first round down, took pictures to send to Matt, you know, to really perfect the posing here, what we're doing in the mornings, to push each other and mainly just, you know, have that conditioning on point, is we do fit like 15 to 20 second rounds. So that's holding each pose for 15 seconds. So, you know, we go through the whole rotation, core turns, mandatories, holding everything on 15. And the main thing here is just focusing on, you know, hitting the pose and holding it, but also, you know, breathing, controlling your breathing. You know, you want to start this out, you know, for me, we started last week, so about two weeks ago, so 12 weeks out, leaning all the way down into, you know, prep. So if you want to make sure on that day on stage that, you know, you can move up a placing, you know, just from your posing, or just be on point with that, make sure you practice. And then, you know, practice with a purpose as well, having these longer sessions with the holds, focus on your breathing, and get as good as you can.
And
All right, so cardio is done, posing is done. We did about 3 rounds there total. Now we have some time left, I'm gonna do some abs. So I do abs probably end up doing, we'll do 1 or 2 exercises, probably three to four times a week. My favorite here is what we're gonna do today is just hanging leg raises. You know, this is something that you gotta stabilize yourself, you know, just solely use your core to raise your legs. And as you get better at it, kind of slow down, control it. And I think this helps really bring your waist in more. This along with, I've been doing a lot of planks. So we'll do some of these hanging leg raises. And then I probably won't have time today for planks because we're a little behind with the camera stuff. But usually that's kind of what it looks like. And then I just kind of alternate between, you know, like rope crunch downs, decline sit-ups. And we'll show you these maybe in later videos. But I rotate through those. But the main ones I like to do at least twice a week is the hanging leg raises. And then always hit the planks. Side, you know, side, front, side. With these as well. So abs, let's get a few in here and start our day.